Good afternoon to everyone. I am Mansi Jain, the HR manager of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. I'll be introducing you on the topic how to prepare a resume on for air hostess or the cabin crew. So let's get started. First, let us understand about the company. Let us have some knowledge about the company itself. So as the name suggests, Aircruise Aviation. So basically, our company deals with the aviation industry. Okay, so this is newly incorporated company, which is registered by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Okay, so the vision of the company is to be a eminent or a leading company in the aircraft aviation industry, in the aviation industry sector. And talking about the company's mission, we search for the talents in our country, India, who want to pursue their career in aviation industry. No matter they want to become a pilot or an air hostess, we just guide them, we help them, we train them, and we give so many services. Okay, so let's talk about the services of the Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. These are air charters, pilot training, aviation HR, aviation apps, aviation books, aviation blogs, aviation lead generation, aviation link building, aviation expo, aviation B2C, aviation B2B, and many more such services. So very important, the CEO of our company is Captain Shekhar Gupta. Okay, so now let's come to our main topic. Who's an HR or who is an air hostess? The air hostess, according to me, is the most important person in the aviation sector. So air hostess is the most important person after our pilots. The air hostess is the one who deals with every kind of people, whether they are argumentative or they are aggressive or they are kind, they are polite. They have to deal with every kind of people they come to contact. So talking about the eligibility of becoming an air hostess, you have to be 12th passed with minimum 45% to 50%, and you need a graduate degree. The age limit is 18 to 26 years. So some institutes which provide training to the air hostess are Franklin Institute of Air Hostess Training, Bombay Flying Club, College of American of Ariston, Mumbai, etc., etc. There are so many. Now, there are some things that you, some personality traits that you need to be an air hostess. Let's talk about them. The first and foremost is sense of responsibility. Then coming to other ones are pleasing personality. You need your calmness for working for long hours. You need patience for that. You have to be a good physical appearance. You need to have that. It is very important. And you need to have the mindset of taking initiative, because that's the very important personality trait that an air hostess must possess. And there are many skills, like you should have good communication skills and all that. Talking about the pay scale or the remuneration, a flight attendant gets 4,80,000 to 6,75,000 per annum, and a senior flight attendant gets 5,50,000 to 8,25,000 per annum. Now, the top recruiters who hire air hostess are Air India, Indian Airlines, Go Air, Singapore Airlines, Jet Airways, and there are many more such. Now, here the topic comes. how to create an air hostess resume. So you need to mention the following details when you are preparing your air hostess resume. So we can divide this into two parts, for the freshers and for the who are experienced ones. So talking about the experienced ones, you need to mention the details like personal details, career objective, professional summary, your work experience, your academic qualification, your key skills and strengths which would help the company, and your hobbies and interests, of course. So in personal details, we need to mention our name, our contact information, our mail IDs, our date of birth, our housing address and all that. Then career objective, here we need to mention that how your career objective will help the company, will benefit the company in its growth, in its expansion, because your career objective is also linked with the company's objective. If you feel that you are committed towards the company, then you would be, of course, working with full ability and full capacity to make the company grow and to have its good name and to build a good market image. And professional summary, where you have worked earlier, for how many years you have worked and in which industry you have worked with which company you have worked and all that. Then academic qualifications. Academic qualification includes that what graduation you have done, if any, and from where you have done your schooling and how much you scored in your 10th and 12th boards and all that related stuff. Now, the very important is that you mention your key skills and strengths which are going to help the company and which is going to really help in your career growth, which is very important to mention in your resume or the CV. Now, hobbies and interests. Hobbies are mistaken by someone that you do regularly, like listening music and reading newspapers or reading books, but it's not that. Hobbies are those things which you love, which you like to do when you are free, when you get your free time. So when you write your hobbies and interests, that should be in accordance with the what job you are applying for and what post you are applying for. Yeah. So the second part comes when you are a fresher. Fresher also needs to mention all the details about his or her personal details, then name of the post applied, then job related skills. Now, years of experience. There the fresher should mention as zero, because as the name suggests, he is or she is a fresher. Then salary expected. This is the most frequent question being asked by an HR, that what salary do you expect while doing this job? So there you should mention, if you are a fresher, you should tell that this should be a negotiable, because that would impress the HR as well. And as you don't know much about the company, you don't know much about its paying capacity or its paying pattern, so that should be negotiable. Okay, so this is one resume sample I've put it in to help you make understand. So this is all written, that Derek Flugent is the person who is applying for the job of senior flight attendant. He has written all about his personal details, including LinkedIn and Twitter. Yeah, so nowadays LinkedIn and Twitter account are becoming more of more of a reference check background, or more to know about the person. That is, LinkedIn profile gives a gist of the person, that how is she using that platform, or how is he dealing with people, how many connections you have, how many posts you have, what post do you post in that app, or etc. So this gives an information or a deep knowledge to an HR So you need to mention this also, your LinkedIn profile. Now, experience. So yeah, as the person is an experienced one, so he has mentioned about his experience. You can see he has mentioned like year-wise and to which post he has been to. And then he has mentioned about his graduation, education, skills, knowledge, languages known, and certifications, what all he has done. So this is a sample which can be used in making a resume. Yeah. So here I end my PPT, here I end my words. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Mansi.